Well, having acquired the AST 486 desktop, I thought I ought to really do a quick little video on a laptop that I've had for quite a long time, which is kind of like its baby brother. This is AST Premium Exec 386 SX25, and this dates from around about 1990, something like that. It's in remarkably good condition. The story behind this was a chap I knew acquired, I think, four of these, and they all had various different faults on. And he asked me if I could have a look at them, and I was actually able to repair them and get them working. And he very kindly let me have one of them for free. Unfortunately, there was no power supply with it, and the battery was shot. But another story. But they were, apart from the fact that they were faulty, they were actually in cosmetically very good condition. And this this thing, I found an article online that was published in 1991 about this. And I quote from the article. It said, AST Research Inc., one of the leading manufacturers of notebook computers, introduced a new model last week that analysis said will be one of the fastest notebook PCs on the market. The AST Premium Exec 386 SX25 is the first brand name notebook based on a new microprocessor built by Advanced Micro Devices Inc. And it goes on to say that the AST Premium Exec 386 SX25 has a basic list price of $4,795, which includes 4 megabytes of system memory, an 80 megabyte hard disk, a bright VGA level display, a 3.5 inch diskette drive, and the usual assortment of ports. And it weighs 7.3 pounds. I'll have to work out what that is in kilos, but it's actually quite heavy. But it's an amazing little bit of kit, and I'll have a move it around so you can see. There's modem port on the side there, and then down at the back we've got. Let's just see if we can get a little bit better shot on that. The main set of ports at the back. A serial port, parallel port, VGA out, keyboard, and for external keyboard, obviously also mouse, I believe, and the power. And that was a bit of a problem because it's a proprietary. I think it's a 7-pin mini DIN on there. But what I did at the time, I mean, this is, bear in mind, this was quite a long time ago, was the battery was completely shot, so I removed it and I fitted a standard power jack, and I made a power supply for it, into the battery door. It's not quite all I do nowadays, but in those days it sufficed. So there it is in all its glory. So the next thing is power it up, because I believe it still works. I haven't run it for a long time, but I'm fairly certain it will power up. So let's have a look. Okay, let's see if we can get it to power up. I'm fairly certain that the CMOS battery is shot, so that will be all the usual CMOS errors. But I'm fairly certain we can still get it to boot though. As you can only marvel at the awesome speed of the 386 SX25 processor. Should have timed it really. And so just a few minutes to test the high mem. Right, okay. Bit of the DOS prompt, it's not too bad. Let's see if we can run Windows. Oh god, did you hear that? The awesome tinny speaker. Yeah. Windows is up and running. Let's see if we can have a look. Oh yes, look at that. Amazing. Oh, that's just so awesome. Almost impossible to see the cursor, the mouse cursor, because it blurs as it moves, so it kind of disappears from the screen. Oh, this is just amazing. Look at that. Unbelievable. Solitaire on Windows 3.1.1 on a 26-year-old laptop. Awesome stuff.